The action begins down in the mine, where geologists point a Niton gun at various spots in the rock face. The device detects the levels of 40 different elements, including silver. Silver in its natural state isn't silver colored at all, it's charcoal gray. Miners drill holes in the silver-rich areas the geologists pinpointed, then insert sticks of dynamite. Experts haul the chunks of rock, called ore, to the surface. Geologists then test ore piles and blend them as required. The ore first goes into the primary crusher. The machine's huge steel teeth break up the big chunks into smaller pieces. Those pieces then drop through grates below into the secondary crusher, which breaks them down into even smaller pieces. Those go into vibrating cone crushers, which pulverize them into tiny pieces. A conveyor transports the crushed ore to the ball mill. As the mill's large cylinder rotates, steel balls bounce around inside, grinding the ore into powder. A water circulation system flushes the silver-rich powder out of the cylinder and into large tanks, which keep the water moving. To separate and dissolve the metals the powder contains, workers pour in acid. The solution containing dissolved silver is pumped through filter presses. The filter plates are treated with a zinc-based chemical which attracts silver molecules. As the solution passes through, the plates trap particles containing silver, forming a layer of black powder called silver precipitate. This precipitate is composed of approximately 50% silver and 50% waste. To separate the silver from the waste, they first dry the precipitate in a gas furnace for a couple of hours. Workers put the now dried silver precipitate into an oven, along with chemicals which prevent silver from burning off. Approximately 4 hours later, the silver and waste have separated and melted. Workers pour them into bar-shaped molds. The silver, being heavier, settles at the bottom. Workers skim off the waste floating on top. In less than 5 minutes, the molten silver cools and hardens, enabling workers to extract what is now a silver bar. The mining company sells the bars to a refinery.
Now, the process of refining fine metal starts when gold, silver, platinum, and palladium are delivered to the refinery in several impure forms. The lots of precious metals are weighed and tabulated, then the lots are combined with flux, which looks a lot like you're actually making matters worse by pouring a bunch of dirty sand in with the metal, but it's actually a very important ingredient. This flux and the impure metal is placed in a vessel called a crucible. This is made from material that can take the heat better than the material inside it. So the crucible is then put into a melting furnace that transforms the metal and flux into a molten material. The crucible is then removed and the molten material is poured into a mold, sometimes shaped like a brick or other times like an inverted cone. Especially when they use a lot of flux in the cone-shaped mold, the flux fuses with the undesired matter to form a slag that is lighter than the precious metals. The slag naturally floats to the top of the mold, leaving a pure button of metal below. You can then easily separate the metal button from the slag. Once the whole lot has been melted and sampled, it's then remelted and recooled into grains about the size of BBs in order to speed up the extraction process. The grains are then placed into a mantle where an acid solution is used to dissolve the metals into a liquid form. Once the metals are fully dissolved, chemists use other substances to induce reactions that extract the exact metal they are looking for. The results are that you end up with an absolutely pure piece of gold, silver, platinum, or palladium.